Well, hello, boys and girls. It's when we feel like it o'clock, and I'm Pearl of Wisdom, and you're listening to my NHL Pearls of Wisdom. And I'm back on the saddle again. My wife had a little bout with the COVID. She's doing fine now. So I haven't been doing too many videos. I did have to. By the way, thank you for all your subscriptions, and I hope you're enjoying all the collaborations we're doing, because I'm having a great time doing them. We're also going to be steelflyers.com is coming up right away. Coming up, Steel Flyers All Sports Network, man, it is going to be insane. But today, I gotta get into this freaking Ottawa Senators trade. I went and checked out all the other guys, Lego Rocks, the hockey guy, all of that. I'm in the comments section. I'm thinking I'm gonna go into the, by the way, the trade is Derek Stepan to the Ottawa Senators for a second round pick. And as you can see, I got it up on the cap friendly here. Cap friendly, it's the best there. I said it. I thought everybody's going to be like, what the heck is Ottawa doing? To my amazement, there are people that were thinking that this was a good deal for Ottawa. Okay, I'm going to take the side of it's a good deal for Ottawa. Derek Stepan, here we see him making $6.5 million for this year. However, his actual cap hit is $2 million the way his deal was structured. Now, Derek Stepan, apparently, from everywhere I've seen, heard, in New York, you heard rumblings everywhere. I've heard interviews about him, ex-coaches that have played for him. Basically, he's like having another coach in your lineup. He's amazing for young players. He's a fantastic leader. He puts amazing energy in the room. And I'm going to have to say here, because I don't think Dorian is an idiot, okay? But on paper, let's go look at. This is how great of a guy he must be in the room. Because on paper, he had 28 points last year, which is less than the year before. And, you know, he went 56, 35, 28. This is declining production for a guy who, although he's only owed actually $2 million this year, his cap hit is still $6.5 million. Now, what have we heard all year here? We've heard all year about cap room. There's nobody has cap space. Stahl goes to Detroit and basically they have to give up a second to get rid of his contract. Now, Stahl has, I've heard all of these wonderful things from Stahl. He's a great warrior, he's great in the room, great leadership, all of those things like that. Now, I will say this. Stepan in Arizona did play against the other team's top line a lot of the time. You'll see his plus minus here at -4, -2, -7. I don't put too much stock in that. His defensive numbers are actually really good. He's a good defensive player. Now, the question is, why does Ottawa have to give up a second round pick for a guy with a $6.5 million cap hit? No matter how I look at it, for his production at $6.5 million, he's way below the production rate of a $6.5 million player. And if you look at other teams that might have been offering something for Stepan, do you think New Jersey Devils are going to be offering? They have all the forwards in the world. They need defense. They're certainly not going to be offering that. LA Kings, if you look at their depth chart, they have Anze Kopitar. They have the amazing Gabriel Vilardi. They might be trying to find some room for Byfield. The Columbus Blue Jackets, they just picked up their second line center. Are they going to want to put a $6.5 million cap hit on a guy who can't score when they themselves have problems scoring? I don't think so. Nashville Predators are fine up the middle. These are some teams that might, that sort of had the cap room. And I say sort of. It would have been all their cap space. So who was offering up anything to give him a second? This means that Armstrong, who is came from Silver from St. Louis, now for Arizona, had Ottawa on the line saying, we're not giving Stepan up unless you give a second. And Dorion doesn't call the bluff. What is Arizona? Arizona's not going to get anything for Stepan. Nothing for Stepan if the longer they wait here from anybody. Maybe at the deadline they may get a fourth or a fifth, but really, there was very little chance that anybody was going to even get him close to that. So my problem was that they had to give up a second in this cap world where there's not going to be any raise in the cap for the next few years. Now, Stepan only had a one-year deal. He's going to be an unrestricted at the end of this year. It's possible that they could recoup the draft pick, but is Stepan that much of an amazing human being to be able to come over to Ottawa to bring this energy into that room? They must think that Stepan is like some sort of a guru to give up a second round pick. Let me remind you, second round picks right now are extremely valuable in the cap world. The prospect of being able to bring in a guy that can play in your lineup in the next couple years on a smaller salary, on an entry-level deal, is huge right now. Most teams are trying to acquire as many picks as possible, and Ottawa gives up a second for a somewhat aging, he's 30 years old veteran, who apparently must be the craziest some sort of incredible guru in the room. However, he's such an incredible guru in the room that Arizona almost didn't make the playoffs last year, right? So how bad would this team have been if it wasn't for this incredible guru? I guess it's the only word I can say is guru. He must be a spin doctor for the room to be able to get the max amount out of an organization in order to give a second here. I think it's a terrible move. I thought I don't know what to say. On paper, this looks absolutely horrible. Tell me what you think. Now, Dorion has made some off-the-wall moves before. He seems to make incredible moves and then really bad moves. This looks like a really bad move. But tell me what you think. Maybe you know more about Stepan than I do, but from what I can tell, this one was a head-scratcher. I just simply don't get why you have to give up a second-round pick. Why don't you wait until the season starts? Nobody offers anything, and maybe a fourth or fifth. It almost looks like there's a lot of teams out there trying to shed salary. To me, this looks like Arizona should be giving up a pick to Ottawa to get rid of this contract. Now, Arizona has cap room to add a few more players or play around with their lineup a little bit, something that they never had before. And they recoup a draft pick that they lost because of previous poor management. Armstrong, you did amazing, my friend. And I know you're watching, and I know you're feeling proud now that Perlow says, good for you, sir. Good for you. Anyways, boys and girls, that's my full 42. I had to get on here to do that. I had to get on here to talk about that. Tell me your thoughts down in the comment section, and thank you, and have a freaking awesome new year. It's going to be amazing. SteelFlyers.com, All Sports Network. I'll be doing live shows on there eventually daily. It's going to be a blast. Have a great day, everybody. Lots of love to you.